Don't worry. The moment you become born again, there's a purpose. And there will always be something to come and interfere. Make sure that you are watchful and alert. He will go to the cross. They will think that they are crucifying him, and yet he's opening the gate for everybody to enter and see the glory. Don't they ever think what is unknown? It's only a tongue. The writing, the sickness, the laying on of hands, the casting out demons, everything becoming strange, and it causes people to wonder. Say, I wonder if it's real. This must be witchcraft.
Trees will clap their hands. Trees will clap their hands.
As long as you come here and you see the table from above. As long as you see the table from above, your life will never be the same. Hallelujah.
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 Listen.
Reta.
We'll teach next week, but this is going to change the way you look. Your appearance will be a message to people. Your appearance will be a message to the people. Listen. Paul says, when you come, we are an aroma of life to those who believe. And we are an aroma of death to those who don't. Can you imagine you appear? This is going to change the way you look. Thank you, thank you. You can sit down. Let's just read this part. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
John 6 says,
Johane ya borataro are,
when we continue to eat
fa re tswella go ja
the flesh of Jesus,
nama ya Kriste Jesu,
and continue to drink his blood,
re tswella le go nwa one madi a gagwe,
we continually live in him,
re tshela ka go tswelela mo go ene.
Continually we live in him,
re tswelela go tshela mo go ene,
and continually he lives in us,
mme ka go tswelela o tshela mo go rona,
continually
ka tswe go tswelela,
continually
ka go tswelela.
Then it tallies with Zechariah 4,
e lomagana le Zechariah wa bone,
he shall continually supply us with the Holy Spirit,
o tla nna ka go tswelela a re neela moya o boitshepo.
Why do I say it will change the way you look?
Gore ke re tla fetoga di e tla fetola ditibego tsa gago.
2 Corinthians chapter 2. Paul says, we are an aroma of life to those who believe, and an aroma of death to those who don't believe. Are we going somewhere? We are an aroma of life to those who believe, and aroma of death to those who don't believe. Do we get this? Do we get this? Do we get this? So when you appear, you totally change, because you have taken life and you carry the death of Jesus Christ in you. Do we love our Father? John 3. The Bible says, flesh gives birth to flesh, and spirit gives birth to spirit. You must get it. Galatians chapter 6. If you sow in the flesh, you will reap flesh. If you sow in the spirit, you will reap the spirit. Flesh gives birth to flesh. The way you look at this, you might find yourself sowing in the flesh, and in the flesh you shall reap. But if you sow in the spirit, in the spirit you shall reap. When you look at this table, what do we see? It's the spirit. Because this is the flesh of Jesus Christ.
It's the body of Jesus Christ. Not what you buy from the shop. If you see what you bought from the shop, before you take it, you have already sown in the flesh. Then flesh will give birth to flesh. But if you sow in the spirit, you see the flesh of Jesus Christ. You see the blood of Jesus Christ. And that's how it will change your image. The way you look. The Bible says in Revelation 12, they overcame the enemy, the devil, by the blood of the Lamb and the word of his testimony. You understand Revelation 12? Okay, let's go graphically. They overcame by the blood of the Lamb and the word. What do you understand about the word? Not in the flesh. Turn these stones into bread. Listen to the devil. How do we overcome him? By the blood of the Lamb and the word of his testimony. Now when the devil comes, he sees the law written on tablets of stones. He knows Jesus comes to preach the new message which will cause him to be overcome. Now he says, turn these stones, the law, into something that can be eaten. No. Man cannot live on bread alone, but by the word that proceeds from the mouth of God. So they know that we overcome him by the word. When we take bread, the flesh of Jesus Christ, this is in the spirit, not the flesh of man, not the way you see. Are we going somewhere? We are sowing in the spirit. Do we love Jesus Christ? Once you learn from the spirit, you are actually sowing in the spirit. Then from the spirit you will reap. Whatever you do becomes spiritual. Are we going somewhere? Whatever you do becomes spiritual. So turn these stones into bread. This message on the stone is not a message from God. But the devil says, change this one, because I know that the new one is coming, which will cause people to overcome you. When the new one comes, it will change them. So from the mouth of God we live. So now what is happening? The body of Christ, the bread of Christ, his flesh, the spirit, is a book, and inside it is written. So we overcome by the blood and what we eat. They overcame the devil by the blood of the Lamb and the word of his book, the word of his testament, the word of his covenant, the word of his book. So when we come here and eat, we eat, we drink the blood and eat the book, the testimony. So once you eat that, it will change your appearance. It will make the devil to run away, because you are an aroma of death to those who don't believe, and you are an aroma of life. You understand? You are an aroma of death to those who disbelieve, and you are an aroma of life to those who believe. So once you eat this, your image changes. When you appear, you are an aroma. It says they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb. You must see that. It's Holy Communion. By the blood of the Lamb and the word of his testimony book. That's why John began to cry in Revelation 5. Because the Bible says there was no one who could open the book. So if the book is closed and the stones are still ruling, the stones are still governing, the stone becomes the god of this world. But now if the book is opened, we overcome the god of this world together with the devil. Because it's closed, John cries, because there's no one who could open the book. So we are here. If the book is closed, open the book because it was closed. When we open it, there's a message inside the book. We overcome by the blood and the word of his testimony. So, he who sows in the flesh, where there's no message, they will sow, they will reap from the flesh. But he who sows in the spirit will reap from the spirit. So if you are in the spirit, we look at Jesus Christ. We see a book which has been opened for us. We see a book which has been opened for us. And if this book is opened, that's how we overcome. Many people, the problem is the message. The devil can overcome a Christian when a Christian doesn't have the message. Salve Jesus. Salve my father. Listen, if one does not understand this, the devil overcomes you with anything. Because Revelation 12 says, they overcame the devil by the blood of the Lamb. And what? The word of his testimony. Do we love Jesus Christ? The word of what is a testament? A testament is a book. The New Testament. So the devil says, turn the old into something that can be eaten. So God doesn't want you to eat the old. He wants you to eat the new. Once you eat the new, you overcome the old serpent. You overcome the old serpent. You love Jesus Christ. The Bible says, old prophet wanted to look into these things. But Daniel 12, God says to him, close the book. But the old prophets could not look into it. They only spoke about what is going to happen in the new, but they could not look into it. Daniel said to him, when will that time come? When is it going to happen? When will that time come? So all prophets long to see and hear these things, but you are blessed because you can see and hear them. They could not see and hear them, but you are blessed because the book is opened in the New Testament. Jesus says to his disciples, all prophets long to see and hear these things. They could not, but you are blessed. Your eyes can see them, your ears can hear them. So you can overcome because you can see that it is the blood of Jesus Christ. You can see that this is the book which has been opened. So if this book is open, it's no longer closed. It's open for you to speak what you see inside. Blessed are your eyes, because you can see what is happening in the Father's presence. Somebody say, my image is changing today. Say, my image is really changing today. I don't know, somebody will get something today.
You are going to
change. Don't teach this scripture and talk about money. He who sows in the flesh reaps in the flesh. He who sows in the spirit reaps in the flesh. Does not talk about money.
He
does not talk about money. Flesh gives birth to flesh. But spirit gives birth to spirit. This is far above money. You might find yourself taking Holy Communion and eating real biscuit. It's a degraded level. When you eat, you say, this is the flesh. But you don't see the flesh. Now it's real flesh. You get the whole thing. We're going to take real flesh. We're going to eat real meat. Real meat.
You're going to eat flesh today. We are eating flesh today.
This is flesh in the spirit. What is flesh in the spirit?
Silent nama mo
yeng. We are going to eat solid food.
Re dile go ja dijo tsa ditileng.
Listen.
Reta.
Listen.
Reta.
Galatians 6.
Ba galata borataro.
From verse 7.
Go simola ka temana ya bosupa.
Be not deceived.
Lo skala tietswa.
Be not deceived.
Lo skala tietswa.
God is not mocked.
Modimo ga anya tse ga ro ga ke.
For whatsoever a man soweth.
Sengwe le sengwe se motho o se jalang.
That shall he also reap.
Se o ta se kotula.
For he that soweth to his flesh.
Ene o jala mo nameng ya gagwe.
Shall of the flesh reap.
O ta kotula go tswa mo nameng.
Meaning corruption.
Era gore bona bosula.
He shall reap what? Corruption.
Bona botshelo jo bo bola.
Paul says in 1 Corinthians chapter 11 from verse 23.
Paul o rile mo ba Korinte wa ntlha kgolo le sobele
mongwe. This was personally given to me by the Lord himself.
Se ke se nete ka sebele bile ke morana modimo.
That on the night before he was crucified.
Bosigo pele a ka bapolwa.
He took the blood.
A tsiya madi.
And he took his flesh.
Me a tsa le nama ya
gagwe. He said take and eat.
A re tsayang loje.
You get it? You get it?
Awa
tlhologae. This is the cup for the forgiveness of your sins, remember?
E ke seno sa tshwarelo ya dibetsa lona.
Those who don't take it in a right manner.
Me ba ba sa itseng ka tsela e siameng.
They see corruption.
Ba bona e le selo se se sa lesong.
And who are people who don't see, take it in the right manner?
Ke bo mang ba itseng ka tsela e siameng.
Those who don't take it in the right manner.
Ba ba sa itseng ka tsela e siameng.
They don't see the blood.
Ha ba bone madi.
They see grape tizer.
Ba bona e le seno fela sa.
That's a wrong manner.
Ke molaitsa o
fosa ha se. They don't see the flesh of Jesus.
Ha ba bone mmili wa Kriste Jesu.
They see what was bought from the shop.
Ba bona se se rekileng ko lebenkeleng.
They see what was bought from the supermarket.
Ba bona se se rekileng ko mabenkeleng.
Now what is happening?
Go diragalang janong.
They reap corruption.
Ba kotula tshenyego.
He said those who take it in ramena.
Ba ba itse ka tsela siameng.
Those who take it in ramena.
Ba ba itse ka tsela siameng.
They live.
Ba tshela.
But those who take it in a wrong manner.
Ba itse ka tsela fasagetseng.
They get sick and die before time.
Ba lwala me ba ba tlokafala pele ga nako.
That's corruption.
Ke yona tshenyego.
Amen. Listen, even if you are a sinner.
Le fa o le moetsa dibi.
But when you look at it and see the blood and you see the flesh of Jesus Christ, you already see in the spirit, then you take it, you are taking it in the right manner. But somebody can be born again and say, I'm experienced in this matter. But when he sees cool drink from the supermarket and he sees the biscuit from the supermarket, he faces corruption. Because the moment you look,
how simula o leba,
you decide in your mind.
Wa swetsa motlhaloganyo.
The moment you decide,
how swetsa fela,
what do I see when I look?
Gore ke bonang fa ke leba.
What did you decide?
O sweditse ka gore ah
cool drink.
Se notse di
I'm thirsty.
Ke nyorile.
You will still be thirsty.
O tla nontso nyora. Ah
biscuit.
Biscuit.
I'm hungry.
Ke tshwere ke tala.
You will still be hungry.
O tla nontso
tshwere ke tala. But when you see the blood of Jesus,
me fa bona madi a Kriste Jesu,
you'll never be thirsty again.
Ha o no tlhola o nyora gape.
If you see the body of Jesus, you'll never be hungry again.
Ha o no tlhola o tshwere ke tala gape.
This is food that does not decompose or perish. It's in the spirit. Jesus said, stop toiling for food that decomposes.
Tlogela go dira ka thata le direla dikopedi bona. Fa o ja
and it decomposes,
me di bola,
you'll still be hungry again because it goes out of the toilet.
O tlile go tshwara ke tala gape ka ntla go ditswela
ka ntla. But once you see that which is from above,
me fa o simola bona se song
godimo, this doesn't go out in the toilet.
Tsa ga ditswela kwa ntle mo
tsaneng. It's the spirit.
Ke mowa.
You reap in the spirit.
O go dira mo semoweng.
Do we love Jesus Christ?
Ara marata Jesu Kriste.
For he that soweth to his flesh,
gona ene yo jala mo nameng,
shall of the flesh reap corruption.
O tla kotula tshenyego mo nameng.
But he that soweth to the spirit,
me o jalla mo moeng,
shall of the spirit reap life everlasting.
O tla tshela, o tla roba botshelo.
If you sow to your flesh,
me fa o jalla mo nameng,
you eat
wa
to feed your flesh,
go fepa nama,
and you will reap from the flesh.
Me o tla kotula mo nameng.
Because you eat to feed your flesh,
o jela gore o fepe nama.
You eat to make your flesh strong.
O dira o jela gore o natla fatsana.
But he that sows in the spirit,
ni ene yo jala mo moeng,
shall reap in the spirit.
O tla kotula mo moeng.
So what is the testament?
Testament ke.
Testament is like a will which the people, you know, you draw a will so that when you die your children can benefit.
Testament e tsana le lokwalo tsho lo lokwala bana ba ga
gore ba se le ba mo khene. You will never inherit anything from you as long as you are still alive.
Bana ba ga ba mo khele sepe ga santse wena o tshela.
Until you die.
Go fitela o tlhokafala.
That's when they will reap something.
Ke mo ba kotulang seng.
So until Jesus died.
Go fitela Jesu a
tswa. The book was opened.
Buka intsi.
We found our inheritance.
Ra bona lefa la rona.
And we overcome the devil. Because the book was opened. That's why John cried. There's no one who can open the book. And all the seals thereof. Now the angel comes. Do not worry. Do not weep. The lion of the tribe of Judah. He prevailed. And he overcame. He's able to open the book. He opened the book and all the seals thereof. Once this book is opened in the spirit, you reap. So once your parents die, that's when the book is open. When Jesus died, that's when it opened. Do we love our father? Do we love our father? Do we love our father? Listen. And let us not be weary in well doing. For in due season we shall reap. If we faint not. Say to your neighbor, keep on believing. Say keep on believing. Listen. Hallelujah.
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 Say I love you Jesus. For I'm starting from verse 15. For in Christ Jesus, neither circumcision availeth anything, nor uncircumcision, but a new creature. And as many as walk according to this rule, peace be on them, and mercy. And upon the Israelite of God. For from henceforth. Listen, you want to reap in the spirit. You want to reap in the spirit. You want to reap in the spirit. You want to see yourself changing. You want to have another image. You want to be an aroma. Listen. From henceforth. Let no man trouble me. Do you want to reap in the spirit? Are you troubled by many people? You want to get this? Remember, God said, you know, God was giving the word to Joshua. He said, let it be in your mouth. Meditate upon it day and night. You understand? Put it into practice. And you will be prosperous in every way. Now before that, he said, if you keep this, no man shall stand before you all the days of your life. No man shall stand before you. Did you hear Amplified when he explained when Peter was talking to Jesus? Amplified says, flesh and blood. Man, meaning man, did not reveal this to you. He who sow in the flesh shall reap from what comes from men. But if men comes against you, let no man touch me. I don't know if you get this. Be careful what you do, because when you eat this, you change. You eat this, you change. Flesh and blood, meaning men, did not reveal this to you, but it is my Father in heaven. So you must eat the flesh of Christ in the spirit. Because if it's from men, you bought it from the supermarket. Flesh and blood, man did not reveal this to you, but it is my Father in heaven. So at the death of Jesus, the Father reveals what we could not see before. The Father reveals an inheritance will be waiting for. Are we going somewhere? Are we going somewhere? Now listen. 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 From henceforth, let no man trouble me. Let no man trouble me. So Jesus says, it's not men who can reveal, but it is my Father. So God sent him, his son, to reveal, to open the book, so that we can see. God sent him to reveal. This is flesh in the spirit, not flesh on earth. Are we going somewhere? Do we love Jesus Christ? Do we love Jesus Christ? Say love my Father. We do not fight flesh and blood. You must get it. Huh? We do not fight men, but we fight rulers. You see, it's flesh
Kenama.
And in the spirit again.
Momo en
kabe. Rulers and principalities are spiritual as well.
Babuso le dipuso.
So if you are spiritual,
faule momo en.
Get away from flesh.
Tsobona me.
And be in the spirit.
Me otsana momo en.
Eat from the spirit.
Eja go tswa momo en.
So that you can fight what is in the spirit.
O lwantse se se le momo en.
Hallelujah.
They overcame him. By the blood of the Lamb and the word of his testimony. Meaning when you eat it, you come in the spirit, then you are able to fight rulers and authorities. But if you don't see it rightly, you fight flesh and blood men who come against you. Men. And when he comes against you, the devil takes over. So God says to Joshua,
Joshua,
no man will stand before you all the days of your life. Did God say the devil? He said man. But when you sow in the flesh, man will overcome you before even the devil overcomes you. Do you love a father? Do you love a father?
I mean,
we are Christians.
Christ.
We must be overcomers. We must overcome anything. The thing is, people take Holy Communion religiously. This helped me to overcome a lot. The video which was spread all over the world in January, that was the day we were having Holy Communion. So they had to spread aroma all over the world. They spread aroma. They looked at it in a negative way. Yet today I reap in the spirit. Everybody is looking for me. They want this power. They want this glory. They want, because now today, reaping is in the spirit. They sow in the flesh. I sow in the spirit. And you can't sow where I've already sown. I don't know if you get this. You can't sow. If I've sown in the spirit, you always reap behind. You always sow behind. Listen, you must get it. People who sow in the spirit are already at the front. Look, we are doing it at the same time. This one sows in the spirit. This one sows in the flesh. But he who sows in the spirit is sowing ahead of this one who sows in the flesh. So when you sow ahead in the spirit, this one is too late. This one is too late. It's too late. Because if we sow in the spirit, we are at the front. They may try to attack you. They may try to say we spread this word around. We spread bad news. They spread an aroma to cause people to realize that nobody could overcome this. It means the devil has been overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of his testimony. You understand this? This will help you. Because when we take this, we are busy sowing in the spirit. When you go out there, whoever tries to come against you are already ahead of that person. You are already ahead of that person. Do you love Jesus Christ? Do you love Jesus Christ? Do you love our Father? Right. You take out money, you buy this from the supermarket. You are sowing. How do you see what you bought? Did you sow in the spirit or did you sow in the flesh? When you buy, Father, I thank you. It's no longer from the supermarket. It's from the Father. This is revealed by the Father, not the man that you bought from. You get it, ne? You understand this, ne? You buy it from man. You gave money to him. But when you take it, you don't say, I thank you. You thank the Father. Because after all, who gave you the money? It's the Father who gave you the money. If the Father gave you the money to buy, you say, Father, I thank you. You don't thank this one. If you thank this one, you eat from this one. He revealed this to you. But if you say, Father, I thank you, this was revealed to you by the Father. Now you are able to know who is this. You'll be able to see who is this. And if you know who is this, you won't call him who.
How no mitor kimang?
Kwena
ma.
Mana.
Mana.
Remember, mana means what,
it means
what is this?
It
means people didn't know what they were eating. So they sown in the flesh. And they were reaping in the flesh. But if you know, you are reaping from above. That's why Jesus said, it is not Moses who gave them The bread. Jesus doesn't say the manna.
Jesus,
he says the bread. He says, it is my Father.
When
he says, show us the bread, I am the bread. He says, I am the bread. So they were with him. They could not see him. So if you eat knowing who he is, your eyes are opened. You know who you're eating. And once you eat, you get nurtured. Your body changes. From henceforth, no man. Are we going somewhere?
Amen.
From henceforth, no man. Say to your neighbor, no man. Say, no man must trouble me. For I bear on my body the marks of the Lord Jesus. You eat this. You eat what has been crucified. So you are no longer alive. You bear on your body the marks of Jesus Christ. Whoever touches you, they no longer touch your body. It's no longer your body, but it is the temple of the Holy Ghost. It's the body of Christ. I don't know if you get this. Do you hear this? He says, from henceforth, no man must trouble me. For I bear on my body the marks of the Lord Jesus Christ. I bear on my body. So you will change your form. When they look at you, the marks of Jesus Christ. Not your marks. Not your marks. There are people who get hurt. They remain with their hurt. But there are those who get hurt. When you get hurt, the marks that you get, you will not say, I have a mark. This is the mark of Jesus Christ. This is the mark of who? Of Jesus Christ. So wherever you go, you are an aroma. Do we love Jesus Christ? Do we love Jesus Christ? When we come here, everybody look here. See the throne. See the Lamb of God as though we have been slain. See the Lamb of God as though he has been slain.
Crucified.
See the flesh of the Lamb. And blood coming out of it. And blood coming out of it. Are we going somewhere? You see the lamp and the blood coming out. And when you come here, you come to the throne. So we eat from there? From the throne. Do we love Jesus Christ? Where are we sowing? Just like what we said in the morning. Wrong decision making. Because when we eat, your decision is involved. What do you see on the plate? You can even come, this is beetroot, this is mesh, this is rice, this is flesh, this is flesh. But when you are in the spirit, you see the flesh of Jesus Christ. You see the flesh of Jesus Christ. What you drink, you see the blood of Jesus Christ. Do we love our Father? Do we love our Jesus Christ? Do we love Jesus Christ? Listen. Any man who eats garlic, you will hear with the aroma. I don't know if you get this. They said to Moses, we remember the meat, the fish, the garlics and the onions we used to eat in Egypt, and you brought us here to die. But God brought the flesh from above, which they did not recognize. If you eat garlic yesterday, today you are going to hear that you eat garlic, because there's an aroma. If you eat the flesh of Jesus in the spirit, tomorrow they will know, because on you marks of Jesus Christ are there. So let no man touch you, because you bear the marks of Jesus Christ. Wherever you go, you bring out the aroma. You bring the aroma. Do we love our Father? Listen, some people, wherever we go, it's not that they want to cause things not to be there and happen. You know, wherever we go, There's always friction.
Khona le tlhaka tlhaka.
We just came back from crusade.
Re tswa tseletseo.
When you arrive there, people were
goroga ko.
Many were criticizing, they didn't want that to happen.
Bontsi bana ba tswadi phosa ba sa batle
diragale.
Bana ba sa batle tseletseo ya rona.
It's not that is happening just.
Ha se gore se o se diragala fela.
An aroma comes and people get shocked. What is happening? An aroma. So now an aroma of death is on the way. What is it going to do? It's another gospel which is going to cancel the old gospel. And this causes division. Do you love our Father? Do you love Jesus Christ? 2 Corinthians. 'Cause I love you, Jesus.
Because
I love my Father. Okay, start from verse 14. Start to read from verse 14.
Rebisa go simola ka temana le
some. Second Corinthians chapter 2.
Le bone. Khala ya bobedi.
But thanks be to God, who in Christ always leads us in triumph as trophies of Christ's victory.
You become a trophy of Christ's victory.
Ona se jana sa phenyo ya motho.
Victory from what?
Phenyo ya eng?
From the cross.
Go tswa se fapa no.
What do we eat?
Re ja eng?
We eat the death of Jesus.
Re ja leso la Jesu.
His death brought me life.
Leso la leng tlisetse botshelo.
Are we going somewhere?
Ara gongwe.
Are we going somewhere?
Ara gongwe.
Do you want to be a trophy of Christ's victory?
O batla go nna se jana sa phenyo ya motho.
Read there.
And through us spreads and makes evident.
Through who?
Us.
Kamang.
Through who?
Kamang.
He spreads what?
Go phasalatswa eng?
Through us.
Ka rona.
We are trophies of Christ's victory.
Re di tsana tsa phenyo ya
motho. So through us.
Me ka rona.
What is being spread?
Go phasaladiwa eng?
Read.
The fragrance of the knowledge of God everywhere.
The fragrance of the knowledge of God everywhere.
Lung
the fragrance of the
way.
They overcame the devil by the blood and the and the weight, the fragrance of what? Of the knowledge of God. Once you eat the book, you eat his flesh, and it's in the spirit. Wherever you go, you spread the fragrance of the knowledge of God. So once you spread the fragrance, the devil is saying, I cannot be there. You find men reacting.
O bona batho ba arabela.
Let no man touch me.
Gore go senne motho ope yo nkamang.
Because I bear on me the marks of Jesus.
Tata gore ke rwele mo go nna ma ba di a Christe Jesu.
Are we blessed?
Amen. Are we blessed? Are so go fetse.
Are we blessed? Let's go.
For we are the sweet fragrance of Christ.
We are the sweet fragrance of Christ.
Re lonkolo le monate lo ga Christe.
Go on.
Which exhales.
Which exhales.
Lo le hemehang. Unto God.
Unto God.
Lehemelong modimo.
Discernible alike.
Discernible alike.
Among those who
discernible alike.
Lelos nang parologano.
Let's go.
Discernible alike among those who are being saved.
Among those who are being saved.
Mo gare ga bana ba pulusitsweng.
And among those who are perishing.
And among those who are perishing.
Le mo go bona ba ba yang tatlhegong.
You hear this? We hear this.
Aruka se.
Can you become that aroma?
A o ka nna lonkolo.
You are a fragrance.
O lonko.
What's happening?
Go diragala.
Spread the knowledge of God.
O phasalatsa kitso ya Modimo.
What comes out?
Fa o jeleng, fa o jele go tswang.
Are we blessed?
Are se go fetse.
Let's go.
To the latter, it is an aroma wafted from death to death. A fatal odor.
A fatal odor.
The smell of doom.
The smell of doom.
Lonkola loso.
Do you understand how they overcame the devil?
O tlhaloganya
lo fa the smell of doom.
Go go bangwa ke lonkola tatlhego.
So they overcame the devil by the blood of the lamb.
Ba fanya diabolo ka
manya kwana. And the word of his testimony.
Le lefoko la mpaki jo gago.
The blood of the lamb.
Fa ona le madi ya kwana.
And the testament.
Le testament.
Wherever you go.
Go le go go
ya. You are a fatal odor.
Kwena monko o bolayang.
You are a fatal odor.
Kwena monko.
Because you ate.
Obolaya ka ro tshe.
Now you smell what?
Jano gokhang.
Do you love Jesus Christ?
Ah marata Jesu.
You ate. Now you smell what?
Jano gokhang.
Why?
Gore.
You sown in the spirit.
O jetse momoeng.
A man who's born again is like the wind, the spirit.
Motho ya tseteng seisha o tshona le mphifo.
Wind, spirit.
Ke mowa ke phefo.
Wind, spirit.
Mowa phefo.
Flesh give birth to flesh.
Nama itala nama.
But spirit give birth to spirit.
Me mowa itala mowa.
Do we love our father?
Awa maratara.
Say love Jesus.
Erika kurata Jesus.
Flesh
nama
gives birth to flesh.
Itala nama.
But spirit
me mowa
gives birth to spirit.
Utala mowa.
How do we see that this is spiritual?
Rebona jang gore e mo se mowa.
Do you know Jesus gave this before he went to the cross?
Jesu ba nete se pela ya sefapano.
Huh? He would say, take my flesh, eat.
Are tsa nama ya meluche.
Drink my blood.
Nwa madi ame.
But he hadn't gone to the cross.
Me unaisa ya sefapano.
He knew that this story is written in the past tense.
Ona itse gore le khanye kwa dile mo paka pitting.
And if it's written in the past tense,
kwa dile mo paka pitting,
it conquers in the future.
E fenya mo isa go.
Because it's written.
Ka ntla gore e kwadilwe.
Do you love Jesus Christ? Do you love Jesus Christ?
Ao marata Jesu Kriste.
Do you want to be trophies of Christ's victory?
O batla go nna sechana sa phenyo ya Kriste.
If you are a trophy of Christ's victory,
fa le sechana sa phenyo ya Kriste.
You spread the aroma of the fragrance of the knowledge of God.
O khatsa khatsa le nkolo le monate la
kitso. And when you spread it,
fa le
you overcome the devil.
O fenya
diabolo. Because as you spread it,
ka tla re fa ntse le khatsa khatsa. Go go ene.
Or enemies.
Go tsa mana ba
gago. You are a fatal odor.
O nna le nkolo le phola yang.
You are fatal to so wherever you go. That's how it causes division. Because you ate the testament.
Ka ntlha go jela testament.
Do we love Jesus Christ?
Awa marata Jesu.
Do we love Jesus Christ?
Awa marata Jesu.
You ate what?
O jeleng.
A testament.
Testament.
Many of you, you'll overcome.
Botsi balona litlo go fenya.
As you look at the table.
Jaka o le batafole.
And see him.
O bona ene.
See the blood.
O bona madi.
Of Jesus Christ.
A Jesu Kriste.
And see his body.
O bona mmele wa gagwe. Nama ya gagwe.
So in the spirit as I teach.
Jala mo semoeng jaka ke ruta.
So in the spirit.
Jala mo moeng.
Is receiving the word as it comes.
Ke go amogela lefoko jaka le.
When you come and eat.
Fa o tla o ja.
It will be the fulfillment.
E tla nna tiragatso.
Of the spirit.
Ya semoa.
Do you love him?
Ara morata.
Say love Jesus.
Ere ke go rata Jesu.
Say love Jesus.
Ere ke go rata Jesu.
How many people have been taking Holy Communion?
Ke batho ba le kae ba ntse ba ja selalelo?
And not see the results.
Me ba sa bone ditamorago.
There's so much power in the blood.
Kona le matla mantsi mo mading.
There's so much power in the blood.
Kona le matla mantsi mo mading.
Do we love Jesus Christ?
Ara morata Jesu.
Listen. It's the blood of Jesus.
Ke madi a Jesu.
And the blood of men.
Le madi a motho.
Are we going somewhere?
Ara gongwe.
Are we going somewhere?
Ara gongwe.
Whatever enters the blood of men.
Sengwe le sengwe se tsena mo mading a motho.
Can come there and settle.
Se ka tla mo sa nnela ruri.
And it will be difficult to trace it.
Me ga nna thata gore o se late
di. Until they test the blood.
Go fitela go dirwa diteko tsa
madi. Now when they test the blood.
Me fa ba le ka madi
ao. They will find this power in the blood.
Ba tla fona matla a mo mading.
Which is incurable.
Matla a sa foleng.
I don't know if you get this. They will find power in the blood.
Ba tla fitela matla mo mading.
Because if any man is sick.
Fa motho mongwe le ngwa lwala.
And they can't find out what's happening.
Ba sa kgone go bona re go diragalang ka ene.
They check power that is in the blood.
Ba batla matla a le mo mading.
Once they find out.
Fa ba fitlela.
They will tell you that there is power in your blood.
Ba re go na le matla mo mading a gago.
Which overcomes your body.
A fenya mmele wa gago.
Ah. There is power in the blood.
Go na le matla mo mading.
There is sugar that beats in your blood.
Go na le bolwetse ba tsikiri mo mading a gago.
This is power that came from your ancestors.
E ke madi a tswa mo mading.
There is power in your blood.
Ke matla mo mading a gago.
Because of this power, your body is weak. Because of this power, your body is weak. But when you take the blood of Jesus, there is power in the blood of Jesus. What is power in the blood of Jesus? The blood of Jesus speaks a better message. The word is in the blood of Jesus Christ. We overcome by this word. Do we love Jesus Christ?
Ara marata Jesu.
Say love my father.
Ere ke go rata rara.
Say to your neighbor, there's power in the blood.
Gona le matla mo mading.
There's power in the blood.
Gona le matla mo mading.
If it's the blood of men.
Fa le madi a motho.
Power of sickness.
Ke matla bolwetse.
If it's the blood of Jesus.
Fa le madi a Jesu.
Life comes out of the blood.
Botshelo botswa mo mading ao.
Do we love our father?
Ara marata rara wa rona.
Do we love Jesus Christ?
Ara marata Jesu Kriste.
Do we love Jesus?
Ara marata Jesu.
Say love my father.
Ere ke go rata rara wa me.
If you want to become victorious.
Fa batla go nna mo fenyi.
Believe in this.
Dumela mo go se.
Believe in this.
Dumela mo go se.
That's why Jesus says, stop toiling for food that decomposes or perishes.
Ke ka mo Jesus le ntlogela go dira ka thata le direla dijo tsa di bolang dinyele.
But toil for food that lasts to eternal life.
Me direla dijo tsa di nna ka botsa go
tlile. It means when you eat this,
fa o ja se.
You don't know any toilet.
How it ntwana.
Because you eat and drink.
Ka tla gore wa ja
wa. The Bible says it does not decompose or perish.
Ga e bole le go nyalela
mo go wena. So it's the spirit.
Ke mo wa.
So people who come here today.
Ba tla tla mfa go
pieno. You are coming to take from the spirit.
Le tle go tswa go tswa mo moeng.
That's why he says, stop toiling for food that decomposes or perishes.
But
go for food that lasts to eternal life. So you eat and drink this, it's going to remain in your body. Come on, if you go to Sangomas,
when you visit the Sangoma,
all those herbalists, whatever they give you, those who know you're here, they give you and it stays in you. It doesn't go to the toilet. And wherever you go, it gives you a sign.
Sign of
danger. You ate that. It stays in you. But it can only come out by the power from the side. By the power from our side. We also from our side. We eat from the spread. And once we eat this, it stays in our body. Paul says, I carry in my body the death of Jesus Christ. This one gives me life. So you carry what does not decompose or perish. It stays in you forever. And our side is more powerful than that side. Do we love Jesus Christ? There's so much power here. And this is what you are going to experience today. You are going to experience so much power. So much glory. To an extent that when you meet people, they will no longer act the same like before. You ask the question that said, these people changed. After I spoke to them, you will no longer speak. You bear the marks of Jesus. And out of those marks come the message. A fatal odor. We are trophies of Christ's victory. We are trophies of Christ's victory. Where is that victory coming from? Where is the victory? From the cross. If one grain dies, it produces many. So we sow in the spirit, we reap from the spirit. When he was taken to the cross, he humbled himself so that he can die in order to produce many. He's reaping in the spirit. He's reaping you, you, and you, and you, and you. He's reaping in the spirit. Being born again is the work of the spirit. He's reaping. He died so that he can produce many. Do you love Jesus Christ? No, he's reaping many trophies. That's why you are now a trophy of Christ's victory. You are a trophy of Christ's victory. Celebrate Jesus. Celebrate Jesus. Celebrate my Father. So taking this causes us to remain. And nobody will shake you. If they are fighting for that position, they will fight. But you are there. They will fight themselves. And not you. Do we love Jesus Christ? So love my Father. So love my Lord. So love my Jesus. So love my Jesus. Read there.
To the latter, it's an aroma wafted from death to death, a fatal odor, the smell of doom.
The smell of doom, Do we hear this? Do we hear this, people? Do we hear this? Once you eat this, you change. Your appearance change. You are another smell. That's why Paul says, be careful what you do to me. I bear the marks of Jesus Christ. Something is coming out wherever I go. Do we hear this?
Aruta se.
Do we hear this?
Aruta
se. You change.
Wa feto
ga toga. You live to sow in the spirit.
Tanda uru tsela
go tsala mo moweng. And not sowing in the flesh.
E seng go tsala mo
nameng. Once you sow in the flesh.
Wa o tsala mo
moweng. You teach the law.
Uruta.
You teach the law. You turn the stone into something that people can eat. And people cannot eat the law. People have to eat the word that proceeds from the mouth of God. That's how they will live. That's how they will live. In your hearts. Chapter 3, the same. 2 Corinthians. Chapter 3. In your heart. It's not written on tablets of human, on tablets of stones. It's not written on tablets of stones. But it's written on tablets of human hearts. Not written with ink, but written by the Spirit. If it's by the Spirit, no man can overcome you. It's written by the Spirit. So we sow in the spirit. We reap in the spirit. In the flesh. We reap from men. Because flesh and blood men cannot reveal this to you. Jesus didn't say to the boy, thank you. He took 5 loaves and 2 fish. They came from the boy. He did not say, my boy, thank you. He looked to the father. Father, I thank you for this. Because this was not revealed to him by the boy. This was revealed to him by the father. That this is the bread from above. That's why it multiplied. When it's supposed to bring life to them, because of the way they saw it, it was wrong. It was wrong. That's why the same chapter, John 6, Jesus said to them, you do not look for me because of a miracle, of a sign, or a wonder.
It means
you do not look for me because of the spirit. You look for me because your bellies were full of bread. Because you didn't see the spirit. You didn't see a miracle, a sign, and a wonder. But you saw what can make you to be full. Look for Jesus. Because he is the spirit. God is spirit. And only true worshippers can worship the Father in spirit and in truth. That's where they will reap. Do we love our Father? Read it.
To the farmer, it is an aroma from life to life.
Yes.
A vital fragrance.
A vital fragrance,
Living and fresh.
It's living and it's fresh.
What?
And
who is qualified, fit and sufficient for these things?
Who is qualified? Who is fit? Who is sufficient for these things?
Who is able?
Who is able?
For such a ministry.
For such a ministry.
For we are not like so many.
We are not like so many.
Like hucksters making a trade of or peddling God's word. Shortchanging and adulterating the divine message.
We don't adulterate the divine message of God.
You understand? Amen.
That's how we overcome by the way, which is unadulterated. This is the word that proceeds from the mouth of God. That's how we live. Let's go.
But like men of sincerity.
Like men of sincerity.
And the purest motive.
And the purest motive. As commissioned and sent by who?
By God.
Sent by who?
By God,
you are a trophy of Christ's victory. Yes.
We speak his message.
We speak his message.
In Christ the Messiah.
In Christ the Messiah.
Christ the Messiah.
Yes.
In the very sight and presence of God.
In the presence of God. Who is sufficient? Who is qualified? Chapter 3 verse 5.
Not that we are fit.
Yes.
Qualified and sufficient in ability.
Yes.
Of ourselves. To form personal judgments. Or to claim or count anything as coming from us.
Yes.
But our power and ability.
And sufficiency.
Are from God.
If that power comes from God, you must get the difference. There's power in the blood. Power in human blood. From man. Sickness. It destroys your body. But power from God. From his blood. It's not our power. Our power is ancestral line blood. There's power in anything that you drink. There's power in any food that you eat. Do you understand this? Every food that you eat, there's power. That's why they'll tell you this food is good because it does this to the body. Because there's power in that. There's power in such some drinks that you drink. That's why they'll tell you when you drink this, it does this to your body. But in the blood of Jesus, there is power above us. In the flesh of Jesus Christ, there is power above every power. And that will make us to overcome the devil.